Okay, I had a question, comment, like 2 days ago. I was on my Baikal double barrel shotgun video I did a while ago, anyway. And the comment was in Spanish. I translated it. I think it came out fairly well, I understand. But anyway, they want to see how the safety operated on these shotguns. I think he said his was damaged or... I don't know if it's missing parts or whatever, I have no idea, but anyway, so I figured I could, it's fairly easy to take this thing apart, like take the buttstock off and stuff, so tug the thing out and show how the safety works and so forth. So let's just show the markings first so everybody knows what we're talking about. Made in USSR. This is the model IJ-58M. And I think the M has something to do with it. It's not an automatic safety, but I'm not actually quite sure about that. Because most steel-barrel shotguns, like hammerless or internal hammers, you can see the hammers, they're like right there. But usually when you, you know, use the opening lever here, you know, it moves the locks, but it also pushes the safety would be, you know, forward or whatever. And when you open this, it would shove it back. But this one kind of looks like it sort of kind of could be an automatic one. But there's like this little rod that comes out the back of, I think that's the back side of the locks, or it appears... Because when you open it, it comes back, but doesn't quite touch this or do anything. It sort of touches it, but doesn't push it off. So, but anyway, so when the safety is off like this, you can see there's this wire that's pressed into this sort of triangle piece, and it sticks out that side and this side. You can see the trigger can get by it, same as on this side. So then when you put the safety on, and that thing sits on top of that thing, and then on this side, it moves a smidgen more, but it still won't fire. So on this side, it moves basically very little. So anyway, so it's got sort of this triangle piece, and there's a groove you can see in the receiver that it kind of goes up into, and then there's a cut in it that the safety piece looks like it comes down through, and there's a pin that goes through that, it, you know, attaches this to that, and then it makes it so that can you know, push this back and forth, because when you take the safety off, it almost kind of moves, it sort of tilts this way, and I think there's that pin there appears to be holds it up this way so it can pivot. I believe that's how that works. But you can see how it kind of just pivots on that little pin there, and then there's a coil spring that sits onto a little piece that sticks up out of this thing, and it's like it just sits up against the receiver. Yeah, there's a little hole that it goes in, I guess. And that just keeps tension so that it... I guess when you know, move the safety, it actually has resistance, or, you know, it stays where you put it kind of deal. So, and on the bottom, it doesn't... There's nothing that seems to be attached to anything on the bottom, but it just goes in between these little bars here, like they're chrome plated or whatever. So, I'm not quite sure what this is supposed to do. I don't know if that's... If that was longer... No, if that was longer inside the hole, I don't know if that would. Because of that. I'm not sure what that's doing, but so anyway. Anyway, so that's how it works. I put the best I can do. Hopefully you can see. Hope the light's fairly decent. I got a lamp here, so we got. So I'm not really sure how much of this is missing or what, or like, I don't know how easy it would be to reproduce something like this, because it's fairly simple, but it would have to be fairly exacting, like this little cutout in it and stuff. Like there's a little sort of an angled cut there, and there's little bumps and things. So, you know, down here, as long as you get it so that these sit sort of just so that stops these from moving up. So, but anyway, so hopefully that. Helpful, and that's probably about as good as I can do. So, thanks for watching, and we'll talk to you later.